name is Jonathan Murphy, and I'm the interim organist choir master here at St. John's. I'm also a lecturer at Georgia Southern, of voice and opera and collaborative piano in a number of disciplines. And so we're delighted to have today the Georgia Southern String Camerata. I want to ask you all to make sure your cell phones are on the off or silent position to avoid buzzes or beeps and such. Without further ado, I welcome the Georgia Southern String Camerata and their conductor, Dr. Stephen Elisha.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome everyone to this afternoon's program. We're delighted to see you, and we're absolutely delighted to play in Savannah, and particularly here at St. John's. I first would like to thank St. John's Church, Dr. Jonathan Murphy, and Abby Terry for putting this program, organizing and collaborating with us. And we're just so thrilled to have our association. It's actually Georgia Southern Gretsch School of Music has had a long-standing relationship with this church and the congregation, and we've always been delighted to make music in this space, and we look forward to future times together. All right, excuse me. Last week we performed this program in Statesboro, and as many of you remember, the morning of last week, waking up to the terrible, terrible news from Israel. And it was just two colliding worlds inside of me. On one side, I have to think about our concert that we were about to play, and another part of me just was numb inside and couldn't think about almost anything else. And then it struck me that back in 1963, Maestro Leonard Bernstein had made a speech right after the assassination of John Kennedy. And I was reminded by that speech, and I thought it would be apropos to talk about that. I have it here somewhere. Forgive me for a moment here. I had it just a second ago. Well, even if I don't read it, the premise of that speech, I don't have it here, but the premise of that speech basically was that how do we confront atrocities? We have this unbelievable tragic situation in Israel. We have this unbelievable tragic situation in the Ukraine. We have in our own community tragedy upon tragedy of mindless gun violence. How do we wrap our minds around that? And as a musician, the answer is, as Leonard Bernstein said, to play and perform music more intensely and more beautifully, because that is the antithesis of that colliding world of horror and darkness that we as musicians can bring to our communities, light and beauty and maybe some salve to the soul and the grieving heart. In many ways, when there are no words, we have music. And so today's performance is, in a way, a dedication to that ideal, and that we can offer you, as a wonderful community, our music, and that our purpose as an ensemble is to bring beauty to this world and to enlighten souls and hearts. So we share that with you today. I also would like to bring your attention to the QR code in the on the last page of your programs. That brings you directly to a foundation account at Georgia Southern University, where your dollars can make a huge difference in the lives of these young musicians. It's because of those contributions that actually are enabling every single one of these people here to be part of this music program and to develop and to do things that they never thought were even possible before even coming. There are some people here that are already supporters, and I'd like to recognize them and applaud them. Please give those that are here a supportive round of applause. you would like to be a member of our donor club and our friends of our program, to please feel free to share that. Those monies will enable us in the future to take very important trips. I can't really speak too much about it right now, but there are several trips that are on the horizon where we will be able to go not just to our regional communities, but perhaps to international ones as well. And so we're hoping that we can count on some support that will enable that to happen. Today's program is music that comes between two very interesting time periods. The Baroque time period, of course, culminated with the wonderful music of Johann Sebastian Bach and George Frederick Handel and Antonio Vivaldi. The other part of this is just before Haydn and Mozart and Beethoven came to the scene, and that is this wonderful, exciting time period called Rococo or pre-classical. So we have actually on this program examples of both styles, where we have the end of Handel and Vivaldi and the beginning of this pre-classical time period that features Tartini and Stamitz and the wonderful influences of the Mannheim Orchestra, which was known for severe and drastic and exciting dynamics, subito dynamics, which means where you have forte, loud, and suddenly drop to nothing dynamics. I'm sure you heard some of that in the opening Tartini. So it is a thrill to be able to bring this program to you today, and we look forward to seeing you in the future, and please enjoy the rest of the program.
Thank you. Thank you.